Good job.
On Jumrah Kamatok, Nagan, the Tisamaka, and proud to Kajun to Samajavika, Pekre look Nun here, and maybe talk at Tang some road in the Algipo, and that you mean.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Mr. Coupe,
on the second day of your testimony,
the witnesses were, quote unquote, first and foremost victims. Are you in a position, roughly, approximately,
How many people were, quote unquote, victims?
I'm sorry, Mr. Lawyer, I don't think I can
I was very, very narrow, and I said several times I was tribunal. Among the group of, kind of, Khmer Rouge, we had the largest number of victims. Some of their close relatives were victims. But more or less, everyone in that regime was in some way victims. I know many of them, and I know few ex-Khmer Rouge, who was likewise completely destroyed. Let me try it differently.
May the people pay, you calculated the number of people, about 366 people in your database.
Unfortunately, it's only on very rare occasions that perpetrators speak. Since I published my slogans, I think I have been, like Philip Short, one of the researchers, who thought that perpetrators were also human beings, and that they had bright sides or good sides of them.
And I always treat them as human beings.
And I have been through quite a few states. Yes, but on the other hand, on a number of occasions, I was given the name of an ex-Khmer, the Khmapi Balo soldiers, and that person tended to disappear or run away, not wanting to speak to me. So I would have liked to interview more Khmer Rouge cadres, but that was, of course, very difficult.
To cadres, how do you make sure that the people that you did speak to
Being
involved in were somehow representative sample of the people that had lived in the democratic country?
No,
they were not necessarily representative of the people who had lived under the democratic country. My focus was on the Khmer Rouge prisons. So I was looking for three types of witnesses. First, of course, the victims, people who had been prisoners themselves. But as you know, there were few because the majority were killed. The second one was the people who lived around the prison, so that would give me some information about the movement in and out of the prisoners and the buildings and setting up and so on. And the third, of course, where the Khmapi Bal or the Yothia themselves. So that does not necessarily cover
ដូច្នេះខ្ញុំយល់ឃើញថាវាមិនចាំបាច់ថាប្រជាជននេះត្រូវតែជាតំណាងឲ្យប្រជាជនទាំងមូលដែលរស់នៅក្នុងរបបនោះទេ
Yes, as to counting the numbers, well, let me just say, as to judging the reliability of the witness, I think it's one of the basis of interviewing people. You ask questions for which you have already the answer. You know the answer.
You can check that the people
are telling the truth. That's impossible. So I always did that. The other thing is the numbers. Now, this is where I would disagree to a large extent with the research of Busy Camp, they have tended to inflate the numbers of victims, because then their main sources were the authority of the People's Republic of Cambodia, which tended to inflate the numbers by basically one-third, saying 2 million victims instead of around 2. Also, as the years go by, the witnesses to either, you know, memory selects, as the years go by, people tend to make their experience more and more dramatic, and consciously or unconsciously, they tend to make it even more terrible, and make the number of victims even larger. That's another thing. So my methods, trying to assess numbers, was to try and, first of all, have the duration of the existence of the detention center. Has it been opened before 75 or after 75? Has it been in existence for 6 months, 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, or even more? First, duration of the existence of the institution. Second thing is, what is the rate of arrest? The number of people who are brought, if not every day, at least every week, and so on. This I could know from the people living around, the have some sort of idea. So I would multiply the number of people per week with the duration of the institution. So that gave me very, very approximate figures of the people who were brought to the prison. And as to the number of people who were actually killed there, I tried to assess more or less the number of people who were freed or run away or liberated. And this, of course, I don't know because some of my witnesses, like Mung Son, were freed or some witness could have escaped. So I thought that there was a difference between the people who were brought in and the people whose life was saved. And if you go around the country, the people who were processed through the prison system are very far between. In other words, they're very few, because the vast majority of the people never came out alive.
Like I said before, what are your sources to say that the majority of the vast majority of the prisoners was killed? So far, I've heard anecdotal evidence, if I can call it like this, we have established that you visited less than a quarter of the district prisons. There are no archives of any other prisons other than wide and broad ranging statements.
All right, you worked out that I interviewed 366 people. Now you come out with another figure. Visited a quarter of the prisons I would have thought that perhaps it was a bit more, but
you yourself say less than a quarter of the district prisons
visited a prison.
Well, I never made a count.
Perhaps
underestimated. I've only gone through in the past few weeks the whole of the Bopia region, East region. The main problem. The main problem is each of the, you say 50 or some 50 prisons that investigated corroborate each other.
And also
the entire literature on democratic Cambodia the big question is whether summarily executed we have doubts about that and nobody can give really accurate figures. How do you divide these 2 million people? What is the percentage of people who died of famine and disease? How many people were summarily executed? How many people died in the prison system? We can only make suppositions. And I'm not a demographer, he came with a number of figures. Even in the way the people who were executed, I really much wonder how he could find this out. ប្រទេសខ្ញុំក៏ឆ្លងដែរថាខ្វះអាស្វ័យនៅទូលេខបានដល់របៀបណាដោយសារការសម្លាប់គឺជារឿងមួយសម្ងាត់ណាស់គេសម្លាប់តែនៅក្នុងពេលយប់ Mr. Locard, you said on the first trial day, 11:35,
that you saw the source code, they extend mainly for my interviews. You also said
the first trial day, 11:35, that you saw the source code, Is it fair to say that between you and DCCAM
there is
no the best of relations?
Now, as to my collection of slogans, it is
deliberate
that I wanted to collect the slogans as they were uttered in the
Sahakor,
at the grassroots, in the people's groups, not the slogans that you would find uttered on the radio. We don't quite know because
BBC, FBI,
FBI, public occasions. So you find virtually no slogans in FBIS. I did not go through the Khmer Rouge
literature, the youth magazine,
were mostly adolescents, young women, at the time of democratic capture, and what they remember 10, 15 years later. The slogans that were on the S21 and S22 and the S21 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 and the S21
ហើយក្រោយមកលោកនាយកខ្ញុំទទួលឯកសារកម្ពុជាគឺថាមិនបានបើកចំហការងាររបស់ខ្លួនទៅដល់សាធារណជនទេតើលោកអាចជម្រាបជូនអង្គជំរុញប្រាក់បានទេហេតុអ្វីបានជាលោកគិតថាមិនចេះមិនដុលឯកសារកម្ពុជាមិនពេញចិត្តធ្វើការជាមួយលោកហើយអីបានជាសញ្ជាតិរបស់លោកវាខ្លាយទៅជាការរាំងស្ទះមួយឧបសគ្គមួយដែលមិនអាចឲ្យលោកធ្វើការជាមួយមជ្ឈមណ្ឌលឯកសារកម្ពុជាបាន
Well, I think that in this camp there's not much in the French language. And the head does not speak or read French.
Hi, mayor, Bamba, Chairman, Alexa, Cambodia, Common Chen, Jay, Bizarre, Rang, Tier, Jay, the Bizarre, Uncle.
And DC Khmer is not very open to the public.
I'm
not here to make a claim of DC Khmer.
ខ្ញុំ មិន មក ធ្វើ ការ វិនិច្ឆ័យ អំពី មជ្ឈមណ្ឌល ឯកសារ កម្ពុជា ទេ ខ្ញុំ មក ទៅ នេះ គឺ មក ដល់ សកម្មភាព កម្ម ពាក់ព័ន្ធ ទៅ នឹង របស់ កម្ពុជា ប្រជាធិបតេយ្យ
I'll move on
មេធាវី កូពេ ខ្ញុំ បន្ត ទៅ ទៀត ចុះ លោក ហេនរី លូកា
talked also in
លោក ក៏ បាន
that you wrote
មាន ប្រសាសន៍ ហើយ
but you also said it here that
the book របស់ ពុំផ្សាយ ជាមួយ កសែត ភ្នំ ពេញ ប៉ុស ហើយ នៅ ទី នេះ លោក ឆ្លើយ ថា លោក ពិចារណា ទៅ លើ សុភៅ របស់ Philip Shaw សុភ ដក ស្រង់ លោក ថា ជា សុភៅ មួយ ដែល សរសេរ បាន ល្អ បំផុត អំពី របប កម្ពុជា ប្រជាធិបតេយ្យ នៅ ម៉ោង 11:32 ថ្ងៃ ដំបូង នៃ ការ ប្រកាស សកម្មភាព នេះ គឺ លោក បាន ឆ្លើយ ថា កិច្ច សភា របស់ Philip Shaw នេះ គឺ បាន សភា បញ្ញវន្ត កម្មាភិបាល ខ្មែរ ក្រហម នឹង អ្នក ដតី ទៀត បាន ល្អ មែន ទែន
Can you elaborate a bit on this?
តើ លោក អាច ពន្យល់ លម្អិត អំពី ស្នាដៃ របស់ Philip Shaw នេះ បន្តិច បាន ទេ?
Yes, I have the greatest admiration for Philip Shaw.
ខ្ញុំ មាន ការ កោត សរសើរ យ៉ាង ខ្លាំង
ចំពោះ Philip Shaw. He is by profession BBC representative.
Man, chia nẹt sắc sắc sáu chiều. Thế bên tay tam càng nghe quạt cứ chia đồng nàng robot BBC. Hai quạt mình càng nghe ở Paris phong đấy. Hai đứa chân hai tiếp quạt Arthurse Pavard Yang là o robot. Tại ta bên này tập đại François Mitterrand. Hai nộp bài cai mà tiếp quạt
tê từ
ទី ក្រុង ប៉េកាំង ហើយ ធ្វើ ជា អ្នក តំណាង BBC នៅ ប៉េកាំង ហើយ ខ្ញុំ បាន ជួប គាត់ ហើយ គាត់ បាន សរសេរ ប្រវត្តិ ទៅរូប យ៉ាង ល្អ របស់ Mao Zedong
ថា
ហើយ ទៅ គាត់ ចាប់ ផ្ដើម ចាប់ រំ ពី ខ្មែរ ក្រហម ព្រោះ ថា នៅ ពេល ដែល ប៉ុល ពត ទៅ ប៉េកាំង
ថា
គាត់ ក៏ នៅ ក្នុង ការ ប្រជុំ នោះ ដែរ ហើយ គាត់ ញាក់ ផ្អើល យ៉ាង ខ្លាំង ដោយ សារ តែ ប្រទេស ដ៏ តូច មួយ នេះ
គឺ Got
Tip Smile to David Chandler,
but is also got information as they say in English straight from the horse's mouth. That is directly from the people involved in that regime, the top people. We interviewed people which is tribunal. I'm thinking of Chun Prasit.
ខ្ញុំ គិត ថា ចេះ គឺ គាត់ បាន ប្រមូល ព័ត៌ មាន តាំង ពី ជួន ប្រសិទ្ធ ទេ សម្បី តា តឡាការ ខ្មែរ ក្រហម យើង នេះ ក៏ មិន បាន សម្ភារ ជួន ប្រសិទ្ធ ដែរ ប៉ុន្តែ គាត់ ទទួល បាន ព័ត៌ មាន ពី ជួន ប្រសិទ្ធ
Sarat Ban
គេ ថា គាត់ ជា មនុស្ស ដែល ថា លិច ធ្លោ ជាង គេ
Philip Shaw he's He's been kind enough to pass on to me his interview with me, something which is very interesting, very professional, and I learned a lot from him in this interview, and it shows how much a better researcher he was than me, because he recorded some of his summaries, and some of his enormous worker. I think a very efficient researcher and a very efficient writer that
might all certainly be true. My question is, Philip, you'd far more
Philip Short
បានសម្ភារជាមួយកម្មាភិបាលខ្មែរក្រហមច្រើនមែនទែនតើប្អូនលើមូលដ្ឋានអ្វីដែលថាលោកថាបែបនេះរសារគាត់សម្ភារអ្នកដែលលោកមិនដែលបានសម្ភារមួយក៏យ៉ាងម៉េច
Other people are mainly
I'm answering the question.
Well, you have Pipun, Sun Sikun, Kheo Sampon. I don't think he interviewed Nuon Chia because Nuon Chia didn't want to interview anybody. I thought much more readable and informed, and more interesting. And this question is repetitive. I don't know, I have no idea.
It was not a very serious interview of 30 minutes. Why did you put that on your documents?
You say that this is not very serious.
Look,
it is quite short. at that time, not so many people had interviewed Yang Sari.
Yang Sari had extensively interviewed Yang Sari.
Yes.
អ្វីខ្លះដែលលោកច្រើនជាងអ្វីដែលគាត់បានមកផ្ដល់សេចក្តីកំណត់ទីនេះដូច្នេះខ្ញុំចង់សួរថាតើមានអ្វីដែលថ្មីដែលភីផួនប្រាប់លោកទាំងមិនបានប្រាប់អង្គជំនុំជម្រះនេះ
Well, you will know it, I hope, quite shortly, because I have this time so many recording tapes, so many written for a book. The revolutionary movement In this courtroom, Phipun has spent maximum of 3 days.
I was a very good friend of Philip Short's.
A great admirer of Philip Short's work.
Philip Short, as 21,
should be compared to
Hai lục ban nhiệt tha
security centers in Algeria in the 50s.
Ta ta lục tha 21 ai thiệp tới năng cục của bọn răng nơi Algeria ban tê.
Yes, well, this is precisely one of the comparisons that I put in my copy. I don't have it here.
The question mark,
I was... Well, first of all, I do not know a lot.
Because of the time of the war,
the Algerian war, I was
young,
I was still at upper secondary.
I'm not really in the Algerian period.
Yes, precisely. This has been the subject of the research of Lupinus, from ex-University of Aix-en-Provence in France.
And
he has been starting from the colonial period. Who, by establishing the justice system,
Wooden shackles existed
before the Khmer Rouge.
And chains existed in the colonial period.
During the day, the prisons were changed only at night. Shackled prisoners, torture, and that sort of thing. I think that it was mainly from the Vietnam.
I wrote down how the detention situation in Khmer Republic.
Did you anyone
Well, precisely on that subject, it's a great pity that the tribunals did not interrogate or interview about his experience in Sankum region, the Sankum prison. I think he was in prison almost 2 years. I think it was in Prisor. And he was freed early in the Republican regime. So I think that Dutch had the experience of the Sankum regime in the beginning of the Lundong regime. Because I've attended most of the Dutch trial and I've looked at many things, I'm not sure that he has been interviewed on that matter.
ปัญหาទាំងអស់នេះឬក៏នោះទេសំណួរអ្វីដែលខ្ញុំចង់សួរគឺថាតើលោកមានបានធ្វើការស្រាវជ្រាវអំពីស្ថានភាពប្រូវីនស៊ីអលប្រេសិដិនស៍បីហើយលោកអាចធ្វើការប្រៀបធៀបបានគឺខ្ញុំចង់សួរថាតើកម្មាភិបាលខ្មែរក្រហមគ្រាន់តែបន្តការគ្រប់គ្រងដែលគេធ្វើជាទូទៅនៅមុនឆ្នាំ 75 មកឬមួយក៏យ៉ាងណា
Right, well, you can get information from Kisampon.
ក៏ចិត្តនិពន្ធកើតដែរអញ្ចឹងមែនទេ
Who Khmer? I cannot remember hundreds and hundreds of pages of notes that I
tried to write.
My paper and Gottachan I got here in my
kit out.
I couldn't see you. It was, according to you, a low-level congress in achieve of a village, or achieve of a village
2 kilometers away from Gottachan, a low-level congress in achieve of a
village.
That's very likely.
Potential evidence that you might provide, and all the rest of the evidence that you might be in the possession of.
Certainly, yes.
My
only original, I suppose, research will be my research on the archives themselves. The documents from Khmer that I was handed out by
I was handed out by the same thing. From the mouth of a person from Pennsylvania, did you speak to Pennsylvania?
Yes, certainly, yes. I interviewed Pen Savan shortly after his return to Cambodia. Although, as I said, he was originally from a village very close to Tamok, he chose to go to Khmer.
I have been in French, I'm not sure. 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 I have
I read through my Kantrachan paper, which I prepared for conference organized by David Chandler on the occasion of his retirement, December 1996. I think I summarized reading the paper that Ben Savant gave me, but I'd like to know if I can add any important points.
លោកប្រធានខ្ញុំមើលទៅឃើញថាដល់ម៉ោងជប់សម្រាកហើយដូច្នេះខ្ញុំសូមអនុញ្ញាតដើម្បីជប់សម្រាកបាទអរគុណឥឡូវនេះដល់ពេលសម្រាកថ្ងៃត្រង់ហើយអរគុណព្រះសម្រាកចាប់ពីនេះទៅទៅរហូតដល់ម៉ោង 1 កន្លះរសៀលនេះសូមអញ្ជើញចូលវិញដើម្បីបន្តកិច្ចដំណើរការសម្រាប់ការមុនត្រីរដ្ឋបាលការរំលោភផ្ដល់កន្លែងសម្រាកអ្នកបន្ទុំរងចាំនៅមេផ្សាក់ស្័យដល់ស្័យអ្នកជំនាញរួមនេះនៅក្នុងឡុងពេលជប់សម្រាកអញ្ជើញ ខៀវសំផនត្រឡប់ទៅកាន់បន្ទប់រងចាំខាងក្រោមសាធារណការនេះនៅបកអង្គងភ្នំគាត់ត្រឡប់ចូលរួមសាធារណការនៅក្នុងបន្ទប់សាធារណការនេះវិញនៅរុស្ស៊ីនេះបានមុនម៉ោង 1 កន្លះសម្រាប់ចុះ